if we pursue individually certain goals like being valued by our peer group, our clique, our tribe, our political party, and we're really effective warriors for promoting the sacred beliefs of our coalition and showing how evil and stupid the other coalition is. Well, you know, if everyone does that, each one is rational in terms of gaining brownie points within their group. It's not so rational for the group as a whole.
Right. And so I guess this makes the concept of rationality particularly hard, not just to understand, but to execute on. And so we had Richard Thaler on our series last month. And of course, one of the things that he talks about in his book, Misbehaving, is the idea of the supposedly irrelevant factor, right? The SIFs in decision-making. Like sometimes there are these things in the environment, elements of context, who else is in the room with me, that affect the way I think about the outcome, that affect the choices I make. And so the right choice in his view depends on the context. And so with every shift in context, there's a different right choice. And I suspect the same is true of rationality. And so that makes it hard for people to even be rational, right? Like there's just a lot of cognitive baggage involved in sort of thinking through what the right rational response should be.
There is, and it's one of the reasons why sometimes where we want to fall back on intuition, or we just can't consciously entertain everything that might be relevant. And you can think of intuition as the extraction of patterns that come from tens, hundreds, maybe even thousands of considerations, each one of which kind of nudges you a little bit this way, a little bit that way. You don't consciously know everything that goes into it. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's the best we can do. Although there is an old finding from psychology, highly replicable, that when you compare the intuition of a human expert, a judge, a psychiatrist, a parole officer, a doctor, and you give them some information, like here's the defendant's age, here are his priors, here's what he's accused of, here's his neighborhood, will he show up for trial or will he skip bail? And then you feed some data on who has skipped bail and who hasn't in the past to a simple algorithm. We're not even talking about fancy schmancy deep learning AI network. We're just talking about simple regression that you learn in, you know, statistics 101. Who does better? And the answer is the regression formula does better.
Right.
So I think we do have a tendency to overtrust our intuitions, including the intuitions of experts. Now, we have a lot of reasons to distrust certain kinds of algorithms, mm-hmm. depending on their goals, depending on the data that went into them, but we should apply the same scrutiny to humans whose intuitions are often noisy, and that was one of Thaler's point, and often biased in all kinds of ways.